96.3 FM, The Source.
All right, 24 minutes before 11 o'clock. I used to fly a lot. I used to be a performer, and I would go all over the East Coast mostly, and I found myself on an airplane all the time. And then I stopped doing that, and hey, good morning. And then I stopped doing that, and then I hadn't been on a plane in probably 20-something years. And then about 2 years ago in October, I went with my son to New York, which was kind of fun. And then I went with you, Robin. We went from New York, actually, right?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, the one thing that's obvious, the difference today from all those years ago, was the fact that you have technology. You can now use your phone to, instead of a ticket, right? Mm-hmm. You can find out where you are exactly. Your phone will tell you like where you are, or that little screen on the back of the seat in front of you shows you where you are, right?
Yeah.
Jennifer Couts Clay, I hope I'm saying her name right. She's on the phone. She's the first woman to serve as head of operations and sales for the Western United States for British Airways. She served as the general manager of product design and development at Pan American World Airways. And she provides technical advice and marketing support to the aviation industry. She's got a book called Jetliner Cabins. Good morning, Jennifer. Thank you for waiting through all of that. Good morning.
Good morning, Larry, and good morning, Robin.
Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from New York City, and today we do not have a heat wave. Great progress.
So tell me about the book itself. Is the book, like, for example, did I witness a little bit of evolution in the cabin part of the airplane, considering that I spent maybe 20 years without flying, and then finally I was back in the air again?
Amazing. Well, you must have seen several changes. And you mentioned the Wi-Fi. You mentioned clever technology, for example, apps on our iPhones,
yeah,
telling us where we can check in, showing our booking, our reservations, so we don't need bits of paper in our hands. But you must also, I imagine, have been a bit horrified to see the security lines at the airports, because it does take a long time now to get on board the aircraft.
That is true. I wasn't surprised, though, because we do the news so and you hear all about it. But yeah, that is a huge difference. And I guess it's just part of today's world. Does it affect the staff or the crew that flies on the plane?
That flies on the plane. Well, as you know, they go through a special crew channel. So they are expedited. They don't have to stand the way we stand, you know, for a long time. However, I think that there is generally greater tension now than there used to be in the earlier days. And some ways crew members feel, oh, they're front line if there are terrorist threats.
Right,
so,
right.
Yeah, they really do focus more on the security aspects of their job, because that's what's necessary now.
And you also focus more on people with special needs these days than in the past.
Yes. Now, in my book, and thank you very much for taking on this subject, because it's a very big subject, I do cover accessibility for passengers with special needs. And that's pretty unusual. When the book first came out in hard copy edition back in 2003, Wiley Publishers, people said, no, you don't write about those things. People don't write about those topics. However, when we look at the number of people with special needs, it's obviously an important subject. So yes, there have been great advances over the last decade or so.
Do airlines focus on first class passengers now, or is it all just one class that flies?
Oh, look, there are some wonderful first class cabins flying around the world. I do have a chapter on first class cabins. I have a chapter on accessibility, business class, aircraft carpet, which has to comply with lots and lots of FAA special regulations. So, yes, first class, it is true on the domestic routes here in the United States. We don't see the kind of first class cabin that flies long haul on the Atlantic, on the Pacific. And that's something that has changed over the last 20 years. This move to all economy or all economy plus premium economy or some seats up front, like JetBlue Mint, for example, with stretch-out seats on the coast-to-coast services.
Oh, I like that. I didn't know there was such a thing.
JetBlue Mint.
So are the seats bigger? I'm looking at the cover of the book. Those seats look huge.
Well, now, the app version of my book, which is really full of information, there are more than 6,000 pictures in the ebook app. And yes, in the first class picture gallery, you'll see individual pods, you'll see individual suites, and JetBlue put in this mint cabin, first class cabin. And so you sit into your seat and you've got your privacy because you've got sort of panels around you.
Really?
You have your own TV TV set, and you have your own tray table and areas where you can put your documents and newspaper, and you can stretch right out and put your feet up and really enjoy the flight. So even on US domestic now, we do see some nice changes, and the major US international airlines, talking about American, Delta, United, they all have excellent first class cabins with stretch out individual lie flat seats.
How many? Nice. We have a friend who flew to, and I'm trying to think of where it was. I think it was Korea, and he posted a photo of himself in a bed, like reclining. How many planes offer that?
That's pretty cool.
Yes. Well, that's the way to travel long haul, no question. You know, flights are getting longer and longer these days because aircraft are becoming more and more efficient. And so the Pacific, as you know, at one time, Pan Am used to put down for refueling in Honolulu, in Midway, in Guam. But these days, you have these nonstop flights, New York to Tokyo, New York to long distance points. And so, yes, you have your own bed, and the flight attendants come along with nice duvet and mattress cover. You can put on your eye mask saying, "Do not disturb," or you can put on an eye mask saying, "Wake me up for breakfast."
Really? Oh my gosh. So what about the culture of the worker on the plane? It seems like I saw more men helping out the passengers than when I would fly 20 something years ago.
Oh, are you talking about the flight attendants?
Yes. Thank you. Yes.
Yes. Well, this is a job for everybody, and certainly inside the aircraft, it's great to have a mix. Imagine an aircraft with only women or only men. That would not line up with the demographic mix of the passenger.
Absolutely, right.
For example.
Right.
So passengers really do like to see a mix in the cabin crew, different age groups, male, female, and different languages, for example, for the long-haul flights. So, yes, there has been very great care given to recruitment. And the other point is trainability, because, as you know, cabin crew, they have to check in regularly for training and certification and safety drills. So the people who work inside the cabin are a very special group. And yes, you mentioned maybe they're under tension, but these are the people that we rely on to help us when there is a problem.
I went to your website. Hold on, I found it right here. Jetlinercabins.com. And on your website, you can buy the app, which I think I'm interested in. I think I want to get that one for my iPad.
Oh, great. Well, I wish you happy reading. The app is the third edition. It's very up to date. It's got, as I say, more than 6,000 pictures classed in 24 picture galleries. So you can lock into first class, or you can lock into cabin lighting, or in-flight dining, or business class. And there are about 130,000 words in 16 chapters, plus case studies and interviews with 50 international specialists.
Wow. And I also found the book on Amazon. So for those who want to get it on Amazon, you can get it there. You can also get it on Google Play, I think I saw, right?
Yes, and Apple iTunes.
iTunes, yes, Apple iTunes. Mm. Well, Jennifer, thank you. Do you still fly a lot? I'm guessing you do, right, in your world? You must fly all the time.
I do travel for business, yes, and when I'm on holiday, obviously. And I hope to continue doing that. But at the same time, I do love writing about aviation. And let's face it, this is an amazing subject. There's something new happening every single day.
Yes, it is. Jennifer, thank you for being on the air with us today.
Thank you, Larry, and thank you, Robin.
You are welcome. We'll be right back.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured.